أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين سيدنا محمد عليه الصلاة وأتم التسليم. أما بعد، إن شاء الله today we will continue with سورة الأنفال and we will start with ayah number 38, basically the last three ayats of the ninth juz, and then we can enter the tenth juz in the fourth ayah inshallah. So this is سورة الأنفال and we started. It talks about the Battle of Badr and then how the spoils of war, and then Allah Azza wa Jalla has given the believers advice, and then here Allah Azza wa Jalla has reminded them with the favors that He has bestowed upon them. And also a dialogue to the kuffar, to those who were fighting the Muslims and the believers. When you fight them, what's going to happen to you? And it's better for you not to fight the Muslims. And Allah Azza wa Jalla says here in the ayah number 38, He says, قل للذين كفروا إن ينتهوا يغفر لهم ما قد سلف وإن يعودوا فقد مضت سنة الأولين. So here Allah Azza wa Jalla has given dialogue to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and to the believers to relate this message to the unbelievers, those who are fighting the Muslims. To those that if you disbelievers, if you stop fighting the Muslims, it's better for you. And then if you enter Islam also, Allah Azza wa Jal, everything that you've done in your past, Allah will forgive you. إِيَّنْتَهُ يُغْفَرْ لَهُمْ مَا قَدْ سَلَفْ. If they decease and desist from fighting the believers and enter into Islam, then Allah Azza wa Jal will forgive them everything that happened in the past. Just like the hadith of Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam that says that the Islam forgives everything that passed. And Allah Azza wa Jal actually take all your past sins. And not only you start with a fresh slate as a Muslim when you enter Islam, Allah will take all your sins and all your good deeds and all your bad deeds and He will convert them to good deeds. So you start with a very, very heavy scale, inshallah, as someone who enter Islam. So Allah says, if tell them that Allah will forgive what happened before, وَإِن يَعُودُ, but if they turn back and if they return to fighting the Muslims, to what they used to do, فَقَدْ مَضَتْ سُنَّةُ الْأَوَّلِينَ. Allah Azza wa Jalla is telling them, the sunnah of those who were before you has passed, and the same will happen to you. Allah Azza wa Jalla tells us story after story after story in the Quran about those, the nations that were past. They fought their messengers, they kicked their messengers, they disbelieved with their messengers, and Allah Azza wa Jalla, what did He do? He made the messenger successful, and He destroyed the towns before after them. So Allah Azza wa Jalla always saved the believers and the messenger and destroyed the disbeliever. So here this is a warning to the disbelievers. If you're not going to cease and desist, Allah will destroy you just like He destroyed those before. So be very wary and be very careful. You're fighting the messenger here. وَقَاتِلُوهُمْ حَتَّى لَا تَكُونَ فِتْنَةً وَيَكُونَ الدِّينُ كُلُّهُ لِلَّهِ فَإِنْ انْتَهَوْا فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ بِمَا يَعْمَلُونَ بَصِيرٌ. So I'm going to literally translate this ayah and then I'm going to talk about it. And then here Allah Azza wa Jalla is saying, وَقَاتِلُوهُمْ, and then fight them, حَتَّى لَا تَكُونَ فِتْنَةً, until there is no more fitna, tribulations, and temptations, and problems. وَيَكُونَ الدِّينُ كُلُّهُ لِلَّهِ, and the entire religion will be purely and solely towards Allah Azza wa Jalla. فَإِنْ انْتَهَوْا, but if they stop, فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ بِمَا يَعْمَلُونَ بَصِيرٌ, knows that Allah Azza wa Jal is well aware and can see everything that they're doing. So what this ayah here is saying, those who are fighting the believers, and the believers were mustad'afin, they were weak on land. And then these people are trying to tempt them, trying to test them, trying to harm them. So Allah Azza wa Jal says, we Muslim, you don't stand straight and then let them, slap you on the right cheek and then you give them the left cheek. No, as Muslims, you have to establish your identity on the land. You have to be able to worship. You have to be able to establish your institution, your masajid. You have to be able to have the freedom of religion. And if you can't, حتى لا تكون فتنة, if you can't, if the disbelievers are fighting you and they are testing you in your religion, so this is where we said we are allowed to fight in three instances in Islam. One of them, which is self-defense. You're defending, an occupier is coming to you and harming you. The other one, actually, in two instances, and the other one is defending the faith. Here we're defending the faith, meaning fight them as long as they fight you, so there's no fitna. There's no, you know, they come and they fight you, they occupy you, and they harm your children, and then they start to preach their ways, which is against the teachings of Islam. So Allah Azza wa Jalla says, fight them before they create this fitna. And you see today we're in the Muslim world, we have fitans all over the place. Why? Because we left the jihad way, we left the struggle, and we let the tyrants rule us. And as a result, you know, we're weak, and we can't do anything, and the way of the kuffar is the way that is prevailing, even in our own lands, the Muslim lands. وَيَكُونَ الدِّينُ كُلُّهُ لِلَّهِ And know that the entire religion belongs to Allah Azza wa Jal. So Allah Azza wa Jal says, fight them, kick all the mushrikeens out. And if people want to stay, like the Christians and the Jews, they're allowed to stay. But they have to pay the jizya, as we will see in Surah At-Tawbah later. فَإِنْ انْتَهَوْا If they stop, فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ بِمَا يَعْمَلُونَ بَصِيرٌ Know that Allah Azza wa Jal sees everything that they do. If they stop, it's better for them, just like the ayah said before. وَإِن تَوَلَّوْا But if they turn back, فَعْلَمُوا نُوْ أَنَّ اللَّهَ مَوْلَاكُمْ That Allah is your Lord, that Allah is the one who is sustainer of your affairs, believers. So rely on Allah. If they turn back to fight you, know that Allah is with you. نعم المولى ونعم النصير How good of a مولى, of Allah, the one who is taking care of your affair, and how better you will find of someone who will give you more victory than Allah Azza wa Jal. Then Allah Azza wa Jal here gives us details about the spoils of war. We saw in the beginning of Surah Al-Anfal where Allah Azza wa Jal says, يَا أَيُّ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا يَسْأَلُونَكَ عَنْ الْأَنْفَالِ قُلِ الْأَنْفَالِ لِلَّهِ وَالرَّسُولِ They ask you with regard to the spoils of war, tell them the spoils of war to Allah and His Messenger. So Allah and His Messenger decides how they are divided. And then here Allah is bringing clarity to that and He's saying, okay, this is how it's divided. First, you give all the spoils of war to the Messenger, to Allah and His Messenger. The Messenger, what he will do, he will distribute however he feels is right. But then 1/5 of the spoils of war, after that, they will be given to the poor, to these people that we're going to find out. So here Allah Azza wa Jalla is saying, وَعْلَمُوا أَنَّوْا أَنَّمَا غَنِمْتُ مِنْ شَيْءٍ Any spoils of war, any booty that you collect, فَأَنَّ لِلَّهِ خُمُسَهُ To Allah belong 1/5. Allah is not going to take it. But what Allah wants is that 1/5 be divided to the poor and the needy. That 1/5 of it is to the messenger, وَلِذِ الْقُرْبَ And to those who are related to you. So if you collect a booty, you have to take 1/5 of it and give it to first your relatives. See who is needing your relatives. وَالْيَتَامَ And the orphans. وَالْمَسَاكِينَ And the needy people. وَابْنِ السَّبِيلِ And the one who is traveling. Or the homeless man. إِن كُنْتُمْ آمَنْتُمْ بِاللَّهِ If you truly believe in Allah, وَمَا أَنزَلْنَا عَلَىٰ عَبْدِنَا يَوْمَ الْقُرْقَانِ And what we have revealed upon our servant, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, يَوْمَ الْفُرْقَانِ The decisive day. So the day of the battle of Badr, Allah Azza wa Jal call it يَوْمَ الْفُرْقَانِ The day of decisiveness. The day where the believers finally prevailed over the disbelievers, and the believers now are able to continue and build their identity and continue to establish Islam. يَوْمَ الْفُرْقَانِ يَوْمَ الْتَقَى الْجَمْعَانِ The day when the two parties met, the believers fighting the kuffar, the battle of Badr. وَاللَّهُ عَلَى كُلِّ شَيْءٍ قَدِيرٌ Know that Allah Azza wa Jal is capable and able to do everything, subhanAllah. So here Allah Azza wa Jal clearly is deciding to them how they divide the booties and the spoils of war. إِذْ أَنْتُمْ Then Allah Azza wa Jal is reminding the believers after the victory, and He's telling them, you were victorious even though this is how the situation was. And here Allah is explaining that situation. إِذْ أَنْتُمْ بِالْعُدْوَةِ الدُّنْيَا وَهُمْ بِالْعُدْوَةِ الْقُصْوَى وَالرَّكْبُ أَسْفَلَ مِنْكُمْ So they were next to the valley. They were on the lower end of the... So the land was like this. They were بِالْعُدْوَةِ الدُّنْيَا They were closer and they were towards the lower part of the land, and the other kuffar were the higher part of the land. So they had the advantage over them. وهم بالعدوة القصوى والركب أسفل منكم. And القصوى مكة. You know, they're like closer to, you know, on the Mecca side, you were on the other side. والركب أسفل منكم. ركب بالسفينة غيره وكانوا في موضع أسفل منهم. And then those who were actually on horses and camels on the other side, they were also on a place that is also a little, you know, lower than you. So they were here, and the other kuffar were there, and then their horses and camels. So Allah basically is describing how they were staying, you know, when they were fighting each other. وَالرَّكْبُ أَسْفَلَ مِنْكُمْ وَلَوْ تَوَاعَدْتُمْ لَاخْتَلَفْتُمْ فِي الْمِيعَادِ. If you have actually had an appointment, and you said, we're going to meet on that day, and we're going to meet at this moment, and this time, you would have not met exactly at this time. So the Allah Azza wa Jalla says, even if, you know, if you planned that you will meet at that time to fight, you wouldn't have met exactly at that time. But Allah Azza wa Jalla was planning something. So what did He do? He made them meet at a specific time. He made the believers come in, be able to take a nap and sleep and rest. And then when they awake and they're ready, the disbelievers showed up. And then when they were there, so Allah Azza wa Jalla says, you came to, you know, and your positions, Allah chosen this position for you. So when you fight, Allah has a plan for you and how He's going to make you victorious. Subhanallah. And why لَاخْتَلَفْنَا وَلَكِنْ لِيَقْضِيَ اللَّهُ أَمْرًا كَانَ مَكْفَعُولًا. Why? So Allah Azza wa Jalla will decree a matter that has already been decreed. So Allah Azza wa Jalla wants to make them victorious, and He's already decreed that. ليهلك من هلك عن بينة. So Allah Azza wa Jalla make it clear that people will be destroyed, will be killed, in a very clear, evident way. Thousands of people are going to witness that. So the believers, when they defeated the disbelievers, they ran away and they left all their spoils behind. And Allah Azza wa Jalla says, "I gave you a clear, evident victory." So you were. It wasn't like a doubtful. Oh no, we just ran back to regroup. No, they were actually defeated. It was a war where the believers have killed a lot of them, and then the rest just, you know, ran away. And all their leadership was killed. Every one of their leadership. And the way the battle started, there's Abu Jahl, and then his son Al-Walid, and then there's his brother, and they all stood, and they came, you know, Ubayd ibn Jarrah, and then Hamza, and then Ali ibn Abi Talib stood, and they fought those three against three. They killed them, they killed some of their leadership. And then Umayyah and all these kuffar of Mecca, they were destroyed during that battle. And then the believers, you know, defeat them, a very clear, evident victory. So here Allah Azza wa Jalla is saying, وَإِنَّ اللَّهَ لَسَمِيعٌ عَلِيمٌ, and knows that Allah hears everything and is well aware of everything. إِذْ يُرِيكَهُمُ اللَّهُ فِي مَنَامِكَ قَلِيلًا. So prior to the battle, Allah Azza wa Jal made the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam see the kuffar. He made them see. And the ru'ya of the prophets, the dream of the Prophet is real, is true. So the Prophet, during his sleep, he actually saw the army of the kuffar. But he saw them a small group of people. وَإِذْ يُرِيكَهُمُ اللَّهُ فِي مَنَامِكَ قَلِيلًا. Allah has let you see them in your dream only as few. وَلَوْ أَرَاكَهُمْ كَثِيرًا لَفَشِلْتُمْ وَلَتَنَازَعْتُمْ فِي الْأَمْرِ. But if He has made you see them, the number of what they are, you would have fought and argued among yourselves, and you would have been defeated. لَفَشِلْتُمْ. You would have lost. You would have failed. فَشِلْتُمْ comes from the word fail. وَلَتَنَازَعْتُمْ فِي الْأَمْرِ. And then you would have argued and fought among yourselves. وَلَكِنَّ اللَّهَ سَلَّمْ. But Allah is the one who has made it sallam, made this issue pass without any problems. إِنَّهُ عَلِيمٌ بِذَاتِ الصُّدُورِ. Indeed, Allah Azza wa Jal knows everything in the chests of the people. Not only that, Allah Azza wa Jal made the Prophet himself see them in a dream. So when the Prophet came down, he says, I saw them in a dream. They were only few. So inshallah, we're only 300. We should be able to defeat them, right? But if he had come to them and told the believers, he says, listen, I saw in the dream they were, you know, more than 1,000 and we're only 300. You know, we need to prepare. Some of the believers will start to have, you know, fear in their heart, and as a result they probably would have lost the battle or ran away, because they were not prepared. They were not there to go meet an army. They were there to meet a caravan. That was the intent initially. But then Allah Azza wa Jal, out of His wisdom and out of His will, He made the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam see them only a few. And not only that. And then Allah Azza wa Jal continued, وَإِذْ يُرِيكُمُوهُمْ إِذْ إِلْتَقَيْتُمْ فِي أَعْيُنِكُمْ قَلِيلًا. And even when you met them during the war. Now the believing men, the believers, are standing in ranks in front of the disbelievers, and they're seeing them eye to eye. In even in the eyes of the believers, all of them, Allah made them see the kuffar of you. وَإِذْ يُرِيكُمُوهُمْ, and Allah will make you see them. إِذْ إِلْتَقَيْتُمْ, when you met them. فِي أَعْيُنِكُمْ, with your eyes. So with their own eyes, it's like, it wasn't like, okay, we saw a shadow or something. No, they're seeing in their eye, and Allah Azza wa Jal transformed the look of what the reality is, made them see them much less. قليلا. وَيُقَلِّلُكُمْ فِي أَعْيُنِهِمْ, and Allah Azza wa Jal made you, the believers, even less in their eyes. Allah didn't make the believers look more in the eyes of the disbeliever. He made them look less. Why? Because if Allah Azza wa Jal, if He made them look more in the eyes of the disbelievers, then the disbelievers would have to push harder, and they would be like, oh, these are too many, we're going to fight hard. And then as a result, their sword will be even stronger on the believers. So Allah Azza wa Jal made the kuffar see the believers even less. They were 300, He probably made them see them as 50 or 100. When they saw only a few believers, they said, oh, this is a piece of cake, we can just walk and kill them. So they're coming and taking it easy, and the believers, they're seeing them less, and so they don't see them as much. They see them maybe at equal strength, and thus they're going to fight with their best, with their strongest abilities. Why? لِيَقَضِيَ اللَّهُ أَمْرًا كَانَ مَفْعُولًا. So Allah Azza wa Jal will decree a matter that's already been done. So Allah Azza wa Jal already know that the believers are going to defeat the disbeliever. وَإِلَى اللَّهِ تُرْجَعُ الْأُمُورِ, and to Allah all affairs and all matters return. And then Allah Azza wa Jal remind us with many times in the Quran, especially in Surah Al-Baqarah where we read it, where Allah Azza wa Jal said, وَكَمْ مِنْ فِيَةٍ قَلِيلَةٍ غَلَبَتْ فِيَةً كَثِيرَةً بِإِذْنِ اللَّهِ. How many, a small group of people, defeated a large group of people with the will of Allah Azza wa Jal. When Dawood killed Jalut, David and Goliath, how did he kill him? Allah Azza wa Jal, they were only 300 people, Dawood and his people. And Goliath was a strong army of thousands. But Allah Azza wa Jal made them defeat. And this is again, Allah helps the believers over the disbelievers. Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu. Then Allah Azza wa Jal is reminding us and reminding the believers, when you fight the disbelievers, what should you do? Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu. Idha laqitum fi'atan fathbutu. If you stand in ranks in war against another group, فَثْبُتُ means strengthen yourself. Don't disperse, don't run away, don't feel scared. Know that Allah is on your side. فَثْبُتُ وَذْكُرُ اللَّهَ لِكَثِيرًا لَعَلَّكُمْ تُفْلِحُونَ. And in order to be successful, recite and remember Allah a lot. وَذْكُرُ اللَّهَ كَثِيرًا, remember Allah a lot, maybe you will become successful. So know that you're fighting for the cause of Allah Azza wa Jal. You're not fighting for pride. You're not fighting for wealth. You're not fighting for booty. You're not fighting. You know, here Allah is reminding the believers, and you will see that here later, that Allah is reminding the believers that you're fighting for the cause of Allah Azza wa Jal. You're not fighting to go and gain worldly gains like they do. So strengthen yourself and know Allah will strengthen you and Allah will give you victory. وَأَطِيعُ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَهُ, and obey Allah and His Messenger. وَلَا تَنَزَعُ, and do not fight and argue among yourself. If you fight and argue among yourself, standing in ranks, some people, no, let's run away, let's do this, don't do that, and don't do this, then Allah Azza wa Jal says, you become weak, and you're not strong anymore to fight. And if we go to Surah As-Saff, later in the Quran, toward the end, Allah Azza wa Jal says, إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ الَّذِينَ يُقَاتِلُونَ فِي سَبِيلِ صَفَّةٍ كَأَنَّهُمْ بُنْيَانٌ مَرْصُوصٌ. Allah indeed loves those who fight in His cause, صَفَّةً, in straight lines, كَأَنَّهُمْ بُنْيَانٌ مَرْصُوصٌ, as if they are a structure that is very, very well built and strengthened together by being built tightly together. So here Allah Azza wa Jalla is telling the believers, strengthen yourself. Don't run away. And then, وَلَا تَنَازَعُ. Do not argue among yourself. Do not fight among yourself. And if you do, فَتَفْشَهَدُ. Then you will fail. You will be defeated. وَتَذْهَبَ رِيحُكُمْ. And your strength and your fear that you're going to throw against the enemy and your strive and your drive will go away. Your wind, your drive that is going to take you to defeat the enemy will go away. وَصْبِرُ. And also, you need patience. When you're fighting an enemy and somebody's shooting at you or somebody's fighting in front of you, it is a very, very scary situation. So you need to always remember Allah and know that you're doing this for the sake of Allah and that Allah is with you, and therefore when you go and you fight, you will be able to be successful. وَصْبِرُ. And be patient, because it requires a ton of patience. The shaitan is going to come and play with your mind, and we will see here what the shaitan did. Allah Azza wa Jal gives us a big ayah about what the shaitan did even during the battle of Badr. إِنَّ اللَّهَ مَعَ الصَّابِرِينَ. Indeed, Allah is with the ones who are patient. وَلَا تَكُونُ كَالَّذِينَ خَرَجُ مِنْ دِيَارِهِمْ بَطَرًا وَرِئَاءَ النَّاسِ. And don't be, when you go to fight the enemy, you're not fighting for worldly gains. You're not fighting for booty. You're not fighting for all the spoils of war. You're fighting for the cause of Allah Azza wa Jalla. So do not be like them that left their house to fight you bataran, out of batar, meaning they have everything and they need more. They need more wealth. They want to, you know, batar, wa ri'a'an nas, and they want people to see them that I am courageous, that I killed so many people. You know, so they're doing it purely for worldly gains and positions in this life. وَيَصُدُّونَ عَن سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ. And they are depriving people from the straight path of Allah Azza wa Jal. وَاللَّهُ بِمَا يَعْمَلُونَ مُحِيطٌ. And Allah Azza wa Jal is well aware and encompassing everything that they're doing. So don't be like them. When you fight, you're fighting purely for the cause of Allah Azza wa Jal. And here, Allah Azza wa Jal has given us what the shaitan has done to the disbelievers. وَإِذْ زَيِّنَ لَهُمُ الشَّيْطَانُ أَعْمَالَهُمْ. The shaitan has beautified their work for them to the disbelievers. So the disbeliever want to fight the believers, and the shaitan was like, oh, you're going to become victorious. It's going to go in the history books. You're going to be the person who defeated this imposter. You're going to be this, and then in the history people are going to remember you. So the shaitan is playing with the mind and the pride of people. And he told them, nobody today is going to defeat you. You're so many of you. You're strong. وَإِنِّي جَارٌ لَكُمْ. And look at them. And because Allah Azza wa Jalla made them see them, not only few. Look at them. They're only few. You're going to defeat them very easily. وَإِنِّي جَارٌ لَكُمْ. And now I am your neighbor. I am your partner. I'm going to be with you. So the shaitan is playing with them and giving them, you know, pride and giving them, you know, ability to push them forward. وَإِنِّي جَارٌ لَكُمْ. فَلَمَّا تَرَاءَتِ الْفِئَتَانِ. When the two parties were able to see each other and now they're going to fight together, what did the shaitan do? The shaitan cannot be next to the believers. The believers are fighting in the cause of Allah Azza wa Jal, and they're saying, A'udhu billahi minash shaitan rajeem, and they're remembering Allah. So what did the shaitan? The shaitan has to run away. But before he ran away, what did he say? So the shaitan says, فَلَمَّا تَرَاتِ فِيهِ نَقَصَ عَلَىٰ أَكْوَىٰ. He ran back. He ran and he went far away on Aqabay. وَقَالَ إِنِّي بَرِيءٌ مِنْكُمْ. He says, I have nothing to do with you, to the disbelievers. إِنِّي أَرَى مَا لَا تَرَوْنَ. I see things that you cannot see. What did he see? He saw the angels. Allah sent how many angels? 1,000 angels with the believers standing there. They're going to fight the disbelievers. So he saw this. He ran away. He says, إِنِّي أَرَى مَا لَا تَرَوْنَ. I see what you do not see. إِنِّي أَخَافُ اللَّهِ. I fear Allah. This is what the shaitan is saying. إِنِّي أَخَافُ اللَّهِ. I fear Allah. وَاللَّهُ شَدِيدُ الْعِقَابِ. And indeed Allah is very severe in his punishment. So they're standing. They want to fight the disbelievers. And the shaitan is with them. He urged them to do. But when he saw the angels, he saw the believers, he ran away. He didn't stay with them. He ran away. إِذْ يَقُولُ الْمُنَافِقُونَ وَالَّذِينَ فِي قُلُوبِهِمْ مَرَضٌ غَرَّ هَؤُلَاءِ دِينَهُمْ. So some of the hypocrites, and they were Jews and they were hypocrites, so pretending to be Muslims in Medina. And they said, "Oh, these people, their religious has given them so much pride, and they're going to fight this army. They're going to be destroyed. They're stupid." Then Allah Azza wa Jal answered them. He says, "وَمَن يَتَوَكَّلَ عَلَى اللَّهِ," and whoever relies onto Allah Azza wa Jal, فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ عَزِيزٌ حَكِيمٌ. Know that Allah is the Almighty. He's the All-Wise. He's the one who's going to give you victory. وَلَوْ تَرَى. And then here Allah Azza wa Jal is telling the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, saying, "If you can only see." So, the believers are fighting the disbelievers, and they're killing them. When they kill them, the angel of death are taking the souls of the disbelievers. So Allah Azza wa Jal is telling the Prophet, if you can only see how their souls were taken. وَلَوْ تَرَى, if you can only see, إِذْ يَتَوَفَّى الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا الْمَلَائِكَةِ, the angels are taking the souls of those who are the disbelievers. يَضْرِبُونَ وُجُوهَهُمْ وَأَدْبَارُهُمْ. So even though they were killed and they were defeated, and now the angels are hitting them, they're hitting their faces and they're hitting their backs. So they're taking their souls and beating them up during the instance of taking their souls and taking them out, and they did, you know, putting a strong beating on them, the angels. So not only they got defeated, they got killed, but they got beaten by the angels as their souls are being taken out. وَذُوقُوا عَذَابَ الْحَرِيقِ, and they're telling them and giving them, you know, and taste the punishment of hellfire. So they're telling them that you are definitely going towards hellfire. ذَلِكَ بِمَا قَدَّمَتْ أَيْدِيكُمْ, that is for what you have put forth, what your hands have put forth, what you have done now by fighting the Prophet ﷺ and the believers and try to kill them. Look what is happening to you. وَأَنَّ اللَّهَ لَيْسَ بِضَلَّامِ الْعَبِيدِ, and indeed Allah does not wrongdo people. He is not going to oppress people, but the people themselves are wrongdoing themselves. وَأَنَّ اللَّهَ لَيْسَ بِضَلَّامِ الْعَبِيدِ, and indeed Allah does not wrongdo the slaves. SubhanAllah. So we will stop here at Ayah 51, inshaAllah, and we will continue next week, inshaAllah. سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين جزاكم الله خيرا إن شاء الله.